How odd! All the presents seem to be wrapped up already, except for this one. I've already loaded the last of the sleighs, and will soon be on my way to deliver presents to the children. This gift, however, has no address. It probably fell out of some bag. Please find out who's been left without a present. We have to get to the bottom of this right away. Time is pressing.
It was Frosty who should have got the magic snowflake. It's a powerful artifact, and she's the only one who could properly look after it. Oh dear. I'm not thinking clearly because of my flu. I just didn't want to let the other elves down by neglecting my duties. Instead, I've only made things worse. Thank you. I know I messed up, but I can still breathe a little easier. I swear, I'll make it up to you all. Please help me. We can't leave things like this. We have to stop this sleigh with a snowflake. Open the door, please. My hands are shaking with all this stress. Thanks. Oh, but we were too late. If Santa finds out, he'll be so upset. Let's find the snowflake ourselves and send it to Frosty. This snowflake is special because its five branches grant wishes. In the wrong hands, it can mean total disaster. After all, uncontrolled wishes are dangerous. We need to find out where the kid the snowflake was mailed to is. I might have dropped the address sheet when I was getting the presents off the conveyor belt. Here, take this. It'll help. Good. Now that we know who the box was sent to, we have to get hold of it first. Oh, but we don't have a sleigh to fly on. I'm glad you're with me. Actually, I have a marvelous idea. I just realized that there's an old sleigh. It hasn't been in service for a while and has been almost entirely stripped for parts. But we can fix it, can't we? And I'm guessing this will help. jelly is almost out of juice. What do we do? Well done! Quick thinking, I didn't even notice that button. We landed in the wrong place. Luckily, I happened to bring along a blizzard ball. It's another magical artifact that will lead us to what we're looking for. Except it got jumbled a bit in my pocket, so the magic doesn't work. Here, maybe you'll know how to make it work again.
you doing here? Shouldn't you be wrapping Christmas presents? Oh, no matter. It's so fortunate you're here. I was in a hurry to buy presents for my lady rabbit and the bunnies, but my paws got so cold that I tripped over a decoration and it collapsed on top of me. I'm not hurt, but I would really appreciate the help. Would you mind? You're looking for the magic snowflake? I've heard about it. When you guys were gone, I saw a sleigh carrying presents to the neighbor's house. Except it's hard to get in. Some wealthy people live there, and they only let you in by invitation. But brave elves like you can get inside through the shop's roof. You should hurry. Who knows what the kid may wish for? Oh, my lady rabbit hasn't heard from me in quite a while. Could you please stop by my burrow and tell her not to worry? I still need to get presents for my family. Speaking of which, I remember reading something about that snowflake of yours in one of my books at home. You should take a look. That's so nice of you. Thank you so much. I wrote her a letter and sent it to her by mole mail. But maybe it didn't make it and got stuck in a wall or something. Between you and me, moles are notorious for digging their tunnels right past the sendee. Oh, and take this!
What is it? Oh, a letter from my honey bunny. Thank you so much. I'm so glad he's okay. Please tell him the kids and I are waiting for him. I'm making his favorite carrot cake.
We found him! See how the present is glowing? That's definitely the light of the magic snowflake! Christmas is drawing closer and closer, so the snowflake light is growing brighter. We should tell the boy not to make any wishes.
What I wanted? I asked for a rocket! Bad Santa! Now I want a whole town of candy from you! Wow! It was magic! Hey! What are you doing? Do you want to take my snowflake? No! It's mine now! You won't get it!
Too bad the wand isn't strong enough for the whole city.
Hey, I got home in time to bring presents to my family! I'm really very grateful to you for that. Come on now! I saw where the boy went! Let's go!
Even together, you and I are not strong enough to reverse such a spell. But there's someone who is. Nana Hilda lives in the city. She's an elf and knows all about magic stuff. I've been to her bakery a couple of times. We should see her.
There he is, Colin! That's the elf I saw with the Santa sleigh! I don't remember the other one. Probably knows nothing, though. That sleigh was empty, but you must work with Santa. Which means you know where all the presents are. That's right! We're done with the little kids getting all the fun. You're going to take us to the toys!
Not a chance. Presents are for children, and you're grown-ups. It's too late for you anyway.
That's how you want to play it, huh? Well, you're not getting away with this. our clothes. It's Christmas dinner tonight. Oh, Mom's gonna kill us. It's all your fault, Kevin. You put me up to this. I'm out of here. Colin, wait. Don't leave me.
Oh, thank you. Dear, what happened to reason and common sense? They're supposed to be adults. Let's go. We have to find Nana Hilda.
Christmas, young visitors. Welcome to the Christmas fair, although it's temporarily closed. I know it sounds strange, but as you can see, everything turned to gingerbread. Oh, you here to see Nana Hilda? Of course, she's at her bakery. And since you're here, how about a visit to the magic shop? I run the place myself. There's even a real crystal ball. So how about a sneak peek behind the veil? Lovely! Then I will have it open just for you tonight. Nana Hilda's bakery is just around the corner. Take this, you'll need it.
thank you. The flames in the oven all of a sudden went wild after the little sweets incident. I did my best to make sure my bakery didn't end up too crispy. Oh, but I'm being rude. Welcome. I'm Nana Hilda. Do you two know anything about what happened? The magic snowflake, you say? Well, thankfully, there is something we can do. Flame is just the thing to deal with a spell like that, but it's not strong enough right now. We feed the fire some stardust, then its power will grow and we'll be able to reverse the spell. Must hurry before the boy uses all the snowflake's wishes. Only Frosty can handle this tricky artifact, and in the hands of an ordinary boy, even more trouble can come our way. I'll help you, but my business can't wait as well. There are always a lot of orders on Christmas. However, you can take anything from my bakery. Thank you.
shooting star. Did you make a wish? Just kidding. Everyone knows stars don't grant wishes. They're just fairy tales for little kids. If only it were possible, I'd make a wish to turn back time. Do you think Santa will sack me? Oh, what have I done? Thank you. You're a good friend. You're right. This is no time to wallow in despair. All right. First, we have to find that boy and get the snowflake back. Let's take that fallen star and make flour for the life flame. Are the best elves ever? We are!
Yes, yes, you did a good job. Now, let's see where the boy is. Apparently, he went to Revan's toy store. Revan's a young mage and the owner of the toy store chain. The boy is in the main one of them right now in downtown. The fastest way to get there is by cable car.
Then we'll go at once. Thank you, Nana. Okay, let's look around and find a way to get the cable car up and running. No way! They're the same troublemakers we met earlier! Oh, I'm gonna give them some coal! Yeah, that's not what Santa taught us. We'll find a way to outwit them. Let's hurry up! We need to find Nathan!
Now we can get into the store. Hey, kid, you promised we could take anything. How are you going to do that?
I didn't want you to break stuff. That's bad. Mom says only bad guys do that.
And I say only cowards back down. And I think there's something strange going on with that snowflake. You won't let go of it. That's got to be the source of this magical thing.
Sweet Christmas! If they destroy or damage the snowflake, we're in deep trouble. We've got to do something. To stop them. I think I saw a net in the park. Help me find it.
Thank you.
you're alive! Dibs on all the toys! Wait, Colin! That's not fair!
Something's wrong! All the toys in my store have come to life! Since you helped me with my shop, I thought I'd help you too! Let's find the owner of the toy store. He'll know what to do.
No one follows the master!
Oh, what if he brings other toys to life? We have to stop him! I'm only a fortune teller, so I can't help. But the store owner can. Revan's so good at making toys, it's definitely magic. Anyway, he lives above his store. I'll run back to my magic shop, see what I can find to help you.
Oh, it's all my fault! Come on, maybe we can catch Nathan.
Christmas elves! Perfect timing. I'm Revan, the store's owner. I need to lift someone else's charm from this toy. Would you be so kind as to get me my wand? I can't perform magic without it.
Well done, little elf! A real shame the wand broke. All it took was one spell. Right, now, tell me what's going on here, and why my toys are gallivanting around without me using magic. Accident, huh? Oh, I see. I admire your eagerness not to shove blame onto someone in particular. All right, we need to find this boy, don't we? I'm sorry to have to ask for your help at this very moment, but I need my grandmother's present, a piece of magic meteorite. Right now, I can't do magic without it. The toys that weren't brought to life by me won't listen to my commands. They won't attack children or elves like you, so I'll just be a hindrance to you as a grown man. You saw what that robot was like. Remember, soldiers follow their general's orders. Take this. It will help you deal with them.
You're ruining my Christmas!
Wait, Nathan! This is all a mistake! You wanted your toy. Here it is, in my friend's hands.
Now I can become a real astronaut. When I do, I'll return the snowflake to you. Pinky promise. Robot, don't let them follow me, but don't hurt anyone.
Good idea about showing him the toy. I hope we can win his trust eventually. Right now, we have to break the spell on the toys before we can go after Nathan.
Great! Thank you for bringing my power source. Now I can break the snowflake's charm on my toys and create a portal for you to catch up with Nathan. Will you help me undo the charms? Thank you. With a helper as wonderful as you are, things will go much faster. Only one thing left to do. Draw the magic symbol. Ugh, this robot has made a real mess. Will you please look for the book with the symbol and some paint? Meet me at the store. Here, it'll come in handy as well. I appreciate your help. I will now take you to Central Park. Nathan's there right now, near my Grandma Everett's house, actually.
Everett? Isn't she like a very famous astrologer? She visits Santa's toy factory sometimes. I bet such an expert on stars knows what to do!
To see a star up close. I've always wanted to be an astronaut. No! No! This is not what I wanted! Mommy!
Oh no, the stars are falling! We've got to find Everett. I'm sure she'll help us get everything back to normal.
Welcome. I'm Everett, astrologer and park caretaker. It's a pleasure to meet you. The stars foretold that you would come to me when their falling will be upon us. I'm too old to bring all the stars back up on my own. Would you be so kind, young elves, and get my Skywatcher ready so we can deal with this cataclysm together? By the way, you will find a lot of stellar studies in my office. I'm sure it will be of value during our difficult task. Care to take a look? In that case, you are more than welcome to come into my office. Right. Let's get to setting up my machine. Oh, you found out I'm a fallen star. It's true, but I've been living on Earth for many years now. I have a husband, children, and grandchildren. I have no desire to change that. You've got in a bit of a mess this Christmas. The candy and toys were a particular bother. You will overcome all the challenges. Christmas and the new year will be amazing. You'll help one boy become a better person. He'll make a great brother and a great man. Excellent fortune teller and a kind elf. Well done. The boy is hiding under the Christmas tree in the main square. I can feel his fear. Don't just stand there, go help him.
Come on! Soon, the place will be packed with people celebrating Christmas! We've got to hurry while it's still empty!
Why is it that each time you show up, everything goes wrong? Go away! I'm scared! I want the tree to grow so high that no one can reach me!
What if he falls? We have to find a way to get him down!
Thank you for getting me down. I'm so, so sorry. I just wanted to get a rocket. I'm sorry. I won't do it again. Still, I didn't mean to hurt anyone. I just wanted to feel what it was like to have my every wish come true. The Snowflake has one last wish. I just wish everything was good again, and I could go home to Mommy. She must be so worried. I've learned that wishes are dangerous, and you have to really think before you make one. I'm really sorry.
You've made quite a mess of things, my little helpers, but you did avert a major catastrophe on your own, so it's all good in the end.
Oh, that's it then. All of the Snowflake's wishes are spent.
Actually, since Nathan's last wish was selfless, the Snowflake's magic is back to its full strength and ready to bring joy to people once more.
How wonderful! You know what? You should give Frosty the Snowflake for me. I'm totally exhausted and can't wait to take a nice long vacation to treat my cold and think hard about this adventure so not to make such mistakes again.